All Out Annie. Annie was a stripteaser with only two things on her mind. The second one of these was to go all out for the boys. She wanted to give until it hurt. Then take a long, deep breath and start the whole damn thing all over again. Annie was like that, unselfish. She'd been like that ever since the Christmas. Her parents asked her what she wanted. And she said, I want a watch. So they let her. Now, Annie had very definite ideas on how she was going all out for the boy. She figured herself as the bullseye for the slogan, back the attack. She wanted to be America's number one gin-up girl. After all, it shouldn't have been hard for Annie to go out, because by the time she went all out, no one was further out than Annie, but somehow everything went wrong. She gave blood to the blood bank. 6 weeks later, an entire regiment broke out in bumps. She tried to join the waves, the wax, the marines, the bars, the band, but they wouldn't let her in. Seems their idea was to keep women in uniform. And it began to dawn on Annie that she wasn't going to be allowed to go all out. In fact, she couldn't even lease land. And suddenly, in the dead of night, like the lady in the dark, Annie had a magnificent dream. A dream so real, she thought she'd try it out the next night. She glued war bonds all over her luscious body and had them auctioned off one by one at bond rally. There's a bond for every curve and two curves for every bond. There were $25 bonds on her arm, $50 bonds on her tiny feet, $100 bonds on her beautiful leg, $1,000 bonds on a beautiful breast, and $1,000,000 bond! So perfectly placed. Guess where? They raised every bit in the house. Annie was a sensation. Her hips became international. She sold so many bonds, Secretary Forrestal awarded her a special naval leave. But it wasn't enough. No one had bid for the $1,000,000 bond. Maybe it was the sad look in Annie's eyes, or maybe it was the fact the sight of a $1,000,000 bond made even the biggest bid drop. Then one night when the bidding was at its height, J.L. Klockenstopper tottered to the floor. He was old, fat, and filthy rich. His friends called him the poor man's rich man. Women hadn't meant a damn thing to him since the days of brass hubcaps. The sight of Annie and her $1,000,000 bond made him feel a young 78 again. So he bought the bond with the condition that Annie go with him. That very night, they were married by the mayor. And bright and early the next morning, they buried Mr. J.L. Klockenstopper with the most beautiful facial expression in history. And Annie knew no sacrifice had been too great. For now, with all the Klockenstopper million, she could show every American boy what he was fighting for. Though she had a monument erected in his memory on which was inscribed to J.L. Klockenstopper. He was good while he had it, but he never had it.